Well, hello everyone. I'm Pastor Michael, and this is my ministry office. And what I'm here to do is I'm here to explain my products and my services that I have available for you. But before I talk to you about my products and services I offer, I want to talk to you about the title of my ministry first. And as you can follow along on the PowerPoint behind me, the name of my ministry is Heart to Heart Refinement. And I want to talk to you about what heart-to-heart refinement is, but first, specifically, I want to talk about our heart. So you see the word heart there, okay? And to help you understand what I'm doing and what I offer, let's look at this word heart. My heart, your heart, the heart of those that you love. Whatever we're doing, we're talking about the heart, right? So when I look at the word heart, I see ear in the middle of it, okay? In other words, we must hear something from within our heart, okay? How do I know that we need to hear something, okay? You see the word ear up there in red letters, okay? So this is my heart right here, but inside my heart are my ears. So in the center, I have two ears. So that's an indication that I have to hear something, okay? And whoever created the word heart knew what they were doing because as you can see there, the T defines the word heart. So how do we know we have to hear something? Because in the front of the ear is the H, and that gives us hear on top of the word ear. Okay, so what do we need to listen to? What do we need to hear, okay? What I've done is I have a song in here that I want to do. It's also a video. So I'm going to step off of camera, and I'm going to turn the lights down, and I want you to focus on the video and the words to the song. So, Lord, I'll be quiet so you can hear my heart. Okay? I know in some third world countries this song is going to be muted, and I apologize for that. But the name of the song is Hear My Heart, Lord. You can Google that on YouTube. That's what I did to find it. But in the most part, this song will be playing. So let's talk about our heart one more time, okay? We heard that we need to allow God to hear our heart. Why? Okay. So what I would like to do is I have a poem that I've written. It's called Sometimes It Takes a Broken Heart. And I think it sums up what heart-to-heart refinement really is. So the song, this poem is actually on the PowerPoint. This is the title of this poem. And I'm going to read each paragraph, and as I do that, I'm just going to share the PowerPoint with you so you can follow along, okay? Sometimes it takes a broken heart. Sometimes it takes a broken heart that God must repair and mend. Sometimes it takes one crushed by a loved one or a friend. Sometimes he needs a heart that is full of grief and pain. Sometimes it takes one broken heart filled with regret and shame. Sometimes he needs a heart who has suffered many blows. Sometimes it takes a heart full of sorrow so his mercy he can show. Sometimes he needs a heart shattered and torn. Sometimes it takes just one regret, full of self-contempt and scorn. Sometimes God needs your heart broken and beaten, stepped on and alone, so he may come into your life and turn your world around. Sometimes it takes a broken heart that finally seeks his face. Sometimes it takes a broken spirit to receive the fullness of his grace. Have you ever thought about what the fullness of God's grace is? I have a lot. Okay. This slide says what happens on the inside when we have a broken heart. Okay. This next slide that I want to talk to you about, it shows that it will create a spirit of doubt. There's a video inside this PowerPoint. I'm going to step off the screen and dim the lights, but I want you to listen to that and watch the screen. What choices do you make in your life? How will you choose to live your life? And on whose terms? Will you choose a spirit of doubt, a feeling of uncertainty? Or will you choose a spirit of faith? This is a complete trust or confidence in someone or something. The spirit we choose determines the fruit which we produce. Our spirit is seated at the center of our emotions and reflects our character. Choose a spirit of doubt, and we will produce the fruit from the tree of a sinful nature, such as bitterness, misery, worry, frustrations, harshness, evil, dishonesty, violence, and indulgence. When we try to live on our own terms, we soon will become unhappy and soon begin to feel unloved and empty inside, and our tree of life will begin to wither and die. So as you've seen in that video, a broken heart will create a spirit of doubt. Okay, so I want to go on a little bit more, and I want to talk about what a spirit of doubt is and where does our spirit come in from. I would suggest that we Google the word spirit. Okay, so now we need to address our spirit, right? Because if it's a spirit of doubt, we need to address our spirit. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to Google on my phone what is spirit, and I'm going to have you listen to that. Because I want it to come from something else other than me. What is spirit?
Here's the definition of spirit. The non-physical part of a person which is the seat of emotions and character, the soul.
Okay, my friends, as that was defined, our spirit is the non-physical part of a person, which is the seat of emotions and character, otherwise known as the soul, okay? So what goes on in our soul or mind? Is it well with my soul? So there's an old song that we used to hear in a hymnal in church, right? And that old song was, "It is well in my soul." So what I've done is, I don't want to put it on a PowerPoint, but I'm going to play it on my phone a little bit. And I want you to focus on what the song says a little bit. Give me a minute as I pull it up. Forgive the background noise. I do have neighbors that might just sit out on their porch. I got to get past the commercial. Like I said, I got neighbors that like to sit out on the porch and talk. So it's part of the job, part of the territory. I mean, I'm doing this in my home. So here comes the song, my friends. Just a little bit of it. It's not well in our soul. Okay, so soul equals spirit. Okay, we connected that when we Googled what is spirit. So we learned from the definition that soul and spirit are one of the same. So what happens, folks, when it's not well in our soul? It's heart shattering, right? Do you remember that sometimes it takes a broken heart? This is what happens when we are in the face of adversity, the face of evil, when we are not well in our soul. Can you relate? So what breaks your heart? Okay, you can see bitterness there. You can see our heart is just being ripped apart by a pair of hands, okay? Bitterness that comes from bitter people. How about your own bitterness? Does Jesus want us to become bitter people or better people? Another thing that can shatter our hearts is harshness. Yes, harshness can also shatter our hearts, right? So how do we bear this pain and difficulty that comes our way when in a bitter and harsh world? Okay, I got another video clip that I want you to watch, but it says at the top of that screen, growing in a spiritual faith. Okay, so I'm going to watch this video, and I'm going to turn the lights down again.
Here we go. As we plant seeds of faith, we will have the gift of God's fruit available if we can learn to open our minds and our hearts. We will learn to bear the characteristics of God's fruit, the characteristics of love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. But how can we learn how to bear this much-needed fruit in our lives and begin to see our tree of life grow and come to life? Come take a journey with us as we dive into the Bible and take a deeper look at each fruit of God's Spirit and begin to plant seeds of faith that will make our tree of life come into full bloom.
So, growing a spirit of faith, okay? So, what does it mean to grow a spirit of faith? Well, as you can see in that picture there, that's the fruit of the Spirit, okay? That's a vibrant tree, right? it's thriving, okay, but it's also building something within our hearts, okay? So as you can see, there's a cross that is represented inside that heart, okay? However, at times we fail to understand how the cross fits into our heart, so at this time we may seek out someone to help us, or perhaps that person is already working with you. Who might that person be in your life? So that person that might be in my life, you know, there's a doctor in a doctor suit there, right? So here you see a doctor, but in your life you might have one or more of the people. You might have mom, okay? You could have dad. But what happens if you come from a divorced home and your parental roles are not there, or they're not spiritual led people, okay? So you might turn to a brother, you might turn to a sister, same thing. If they're not spiritually mature and following Jesus, you're not going to understand, okay? So you might talk to your friend, same thing of not being spiritually mature and knowing the way to God through Jesus Christ. So you might turn to your teacher, but you know, in the modern days, our teachers aren't teaching heart refinement. They're not teaching us how to follow Jesus Christ. And honestly, we're not learning that in our churches, at least not the churches that I've been involved with. So we might go to a counselor. The counselor's going to work with our mental stability, and that counselor's going to be talking to you. They're going to figure out what they can do to help you. And but there's no direction that you're seeing in the face of that counseling session. So you might go talk to a mentor. You know, your church might have a mentor, or there might be a youth group that has a mentor for your teenagers or whatever. But sometimes that's not going to help. Okay, so then we get to feeling sick. We get to feeling when something goes on that we need to go to a doctor, right? But sometimes the doctor don't help. So spiritual health healers, that's where I come in at. I'm a spiritual health consultant. I'm a healing pastor. And now I want to talk to you about the products that I have before I talk to you about the services that I have. Okay. So my products and my services come in where you can read about me in the about section, but to start, I want to share my services and the things I do and how I come to create the products. First, after listening to so many people with so much pain in their life, I wanted to do something to help them, okay? I wanted to figure out a way to help people that had so much pain in their heart. I'd go to divorce care, I'd go to Celebrate Recovery, I'd go to Bible studies, I'd have Bible studies at my home, but what we weren't doing is we weren't listening to Romans 12:2. And I'm going to paraphrase this so it's not completely out of the scripture. Do not follow the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Why the renewing of your mind? Okay, so that you may be able to test and approve what God's pleasing and perfect will is for your life. So how do I provide a service that helps people do that? First, I had to be transformed myself by renewing my own mind first. Without the help of Jesus, I could not do this. So the first thing I had to do was refine my own heart. So I wrote a book, but not just one, folks. I wrote many books. Okay, this is the first book that I wrote. This is What is Heart Refinement? This is my cry for help, friends. This is my personal journey here, and this is what brought me into the ministry. And this book is available on the website below me. You can click on it and order it. My next book that I wrote after writing that other book was The 23 Steps to Following Jesus. Okay, these points that are in here come from Divorce Care and Celebrate Recovery. There's a 12-step study in Celebrate Recovery, and the Divorce Care has 13 sessions that you're going to work through too. Okay, so as you notice, this man, he's on a journey. I mean, as you can see, he's walking and he's wearing a backpack. And I wonder if I was going on a journey to follow Jesus, what might I take with me? If you're going to follow Jesus on a journey, what might you take with you? Okay, well, I think we need a map to follow. I think I might take along the map that teaches me how to follow Jesus through steps. He might want me to go on this path with him. Okay, we'll talk about that a little bit later, but in this map, I've created a a guidebook and a video that talks out of John 14:6, four paths, four modules, and a couple other stand-alone books. So in this book, there's four modules there that take us through the way, the truth, and the life of Jesus and the only access to God. That's also a module in there. Okay, and I also wrote a couple other standalone books. On the far side of your screen, you'll see what is true worship. I think that what is true worship has a lot to do with our wedding and our marriage and keeping a strong marriage if we're involved in the right worship service at church. The other book there is I Promise Too. I battled with a lot of people on the title of that book, but I Promise Too is spelled T-O-O with a question mark and exclamation point. Is that the right spelling or is that the wrong spelling? It doesn't matter. What matters is what's inside this book. So that's the books that I've written. Now I've got, besides that last home study that I showed you, this study comes with a stand-up frame picture and an 8x10. Okay, this is the fruit, learning to bear the fruit of the Spirit. We're going to talk about this a little bit later on in this presentation. I know that this is going to get long, but it talks about everything I do in my services. And because I'm showing a PowerPoint, you don't really have to go down there and read all the pages. Just watch the video, people. And something to help me through marriage and family issues is these two books. Life Lessons in Being a Servant Leader in the Home and Life Lessons into the Art of Nurturing. You can scroll down on this page under Products and Services, and under the products you'll see that this is a home study, and we'll talk about this a little bit later also in this service. So services that I provide, okay? Well, first off, my goal is to go to my own mission trip to my own community and surrounding towns, and I plan to do this by doing the following, okay? So what I want to do is I created an A-frame sign, and you can see a picture of that A-frame sign in that PowerPoint. Well, that A-frame sign says Spiritual Health Pastor on Duty Year Today, and it has a list of 8 questions, and if they answer yes to those questions, I want them to come up and talk to me because I can help them, okay? So one of the ways that I help people when they come and talk to me is I give them this book. And in the back of this book has 4 key scriptures written on the back cover that are program module key scriptures, okay? So I also provide a spiritual health checkup form that this book will talk you through that and understand how to do that. So I make myself available via my Facebook app or my website messenger. Okay, so my website has a chat session on there, well, you'll see here in a little bit, and also a Facebook messenger. And so those are ways that you can contact me. And so this is the screenshot of what my website looks like. Okay, and so this is where I do a lot of things. And so the book 23 Steps to Following Jesus is also available in an ebook. So you can actually go through the ebook and then you can personal message me and we can do a video chat or whatever. But you can find me on Facebook Messenger by Googling my name. It's Michael Nicodemus. You can see that on the power slide. Or what you can do, my friends, is click on the chat on the website and you can take that with your name and your email address. It'll guide you to do that, and then we can go from there, okay? So this allows me to be able to email you back and forth, okay? So what I do, once you chat with me, once we have a free consulting session, I'm going to be launching soon Heart to Heart Refinement School. This is my online school where you will be able to have hands-on with me and go through what heart refinement is, where you start and your preparation so that you can start your journey on the road to be a spiritual healthy person with a spiritual healthy heart, and you will be a healthier you. Okay, I do this with the map view and handouts and the Fruit of the Spirit life study plus the life application study. Okay, we're going to look at this here in a little bit. So this is my life application study, not in life application, I'm sorry, life learning kit to learn how to bear the fruit of the Spirit. So this is going to introduce you into what the opposing nature of each fruit is. This is also going to introduce you to what the character trait of the fruits are, but it's also going to introduce you to the qualities of what each one of those are. Where do I come up with qualities when I look at the fruits of the Spirit? Well, a lot of people, you know, I used to run a handyman service. I used to be a carpenter, right? A lot of people tell me that the years of my experience or my character should match the quality of my work. So does the quality of your heart match the character of your heart? That's what I'm going to teach you in this program. So in this online course, we will be showing you the way of Jesus, where it starts out in John 14:6. I also have a marriage and family enhancement kit that I did not put on here because you can look down in there and you can check that out for yourself. So this is the life application kit that we'll do online, and you won't see these books unless you order this kit from me. But these are part one of the Spirit of God's fruit and part one of the qualities of the main. These are the God's qualities that I'm trying to teach you. So in part one of the application, I'm going to be studying 56 scriptures with you. We're going to break them down, okay? When we break down the scriptures, we do that in an SOS fashion. So what is an SOS? Well, we know that an SOS is a cry for help. And when you need heart refinement because of all the bitter and harshness in this world, we need to call on God and Jesus to help us, right? So what does an SOS stand for? Well, the first S stands for scripture. So I will find the best scriptures for you that work best for each fruit transformation. The O stands for observation. So the O, it comes from Matthew 7:24. I say if we hear the, it says if we hear the words of Jesus and put them into action, our lives that we build on the house on the rock of Jesus Christ, it won't fall. So when we observe the words of Jesus, so that's the observation. We're going to hear the words of Jesus. We're going to put those words into action. So when we put those words into action, we're going to come up with a statement of action, okay? So in order to help you do that, I think we need to go back to the guide to heart-to-heart refinement. So after I guide you through the first module on the way, I will guide you through the remaining modules to following Jesus as found in John 14:6. This is a long journey, my friends, but it is. But if you go through it with me online in my consulting services and travel through this map, I promise you will gain access to God and your heart will be healed. You can get started today by logging into the school and signing up for the 2 free courses. Again, soon this online school will launch. Probably here on November 3rd, 2019 is my estimated date. And I didn't want to make this video more than 30 minutes, and we're reaching the 30-minute mark. So this power slide is our Great Commission, folks. This is what we're commanded to do. First thing it says is to go, okay? So go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe everything that I have commanded you. And that comes out of Matthew 28:19-20. That's the Great Commission. All right, so we learned that we need to go. We need to make disciples. We got to baptize them and teach them all that Jesus has commanded us to do. Learning to do this is to learn what heart refinement truly is, because without heart knowledge, our Bible knowledge is dead faith. Are you ready to get started with me today? Okay. This is where we're going to end at, folks. What does this look like to you? This is a scripture out of Luke 9:23. If anyone would come after me, he must deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me. Are you ready to follow me? Check out the rest of my products and service pages and revisit this video as often as you can. And we'll start this journey together. You will see me in this very point in this office doing teaching videos. I'll be doing handouts. I'll be doing the quizzes. you get to test your knowledge and build your heart and heal your heart as you go. May God bless you. May God keep you. And may God's face shine upon you and give you the strength to endure the world of bitterness and the harshness around you. And if you're bitter and you're harsh yourself, please pray. Please pray for that gift of the Holy Spirit to soften your heart, because that's not a very good way to live. I'm going to walk off the screen, and I'm going to go back to this Great Commission. I'm going to leave you that with a few minutes before I turn off the camera. I just want you to stop and just focus on that. Thank you.